of operation. It's been about 3 or 4 years of misery for him. He signed a contract for 10 years at $2 million. So he's got to be very happy with himself with a record of 6-4. So you see, Barrios has a long way to go if Garland is any indication. He knows how to pitch. He'll throw a lot of sliders. Nowhere near the velocity of a Barker, but he will be able to show you how he keeps the ball down, turns it over. It can be awfully tough. Harry, this ball game tonight, we waited a long while to get started, but it looked to me like we might do something. I've seen us several games last couple of years come back against Cleveland, but we made a bad base running situation, and certainly things like that can maybe change things around. A pitch is different.
Well, Friday night, the last game that we played, the Red Sox had a 8-0 lead, and the White Sox got 3 in the 8th and 2 in the 9th before going down, at least made it respectable. And that's what they did here tonight. They were shut out on only one hit in that, a perfect drag bunt by rookie Leo Sutherland. That's the only hit they had had going into the 9th inning. But a walk and two hits accounted for 2 runs. And a long one could have tied up the ball game, but of course it wasn't to be, and you just got to give the guy credit that Len Barker, an outstandingly good pitcher, he now has 114 and lost 8. It was his 7th complete game, and he set a career high for strikeouts in a single game, getting 12.
You know, one thing about him when he was in the Texas organization, he would throw the ball all over the place. He had no idea where the ball was going. And Herb Scorer was saying that all of a sudden, it came to him. Some pitchers, it takes longer. That's why you've got to admire our young pitchers who get the ball over and know how to do different things with the ball. They still showed me a lot of patience. Burns tonight, even though he didn't have his best stuff, a few runs, he's still in the ball game. And the scores around the league right now, St. Louis, after getting 8 runs in the 2nd inning, leads Cincinnati in the 7th, 10-1. Well, that's a big game for Cincinnati. Baltimore defeated the Yankees 6-5. So now Baltimore trails the Yankees as they go out to the West Coast, both ball clubs, by 2.5 games. Minnesota, California. Minnesota defeated California for the 3rd straight time, 8-3. And Brett got a base hit in the 1st inning to go 30 games his hitting streak. And now Kansas City leads Texas 6-0 in the 5th. And Brett was hitting over 400. No telling how many hits he's got in this game already. Detroit, Milwaukee in the 5th. Detroit leads it 3-1. Boston's at Oakland. Seattle's at Toronto. The Cubs are playing in Atlanta. San Diego's at Philadelphia. And Pittsburgh's at Houston as the umpires now come out to home plate. It certainly was an awful long ball game, was it, for a low-scoring game, Coach?
3 hours and 6 minutes. And for 8 innings, one team only had 8 hits. And the other team only had 4 runs. It doesn't seem that that kind of scoring would result in a game 3 hours and 6 minutes old, but for whatever reason, it did.
Well, I was saying before, fouling off a lot of pitches, a lot of 3-2 counts. I don't know, other than we didn't see any real bad plays in the ballgame. People getting off on and off the field, but I gotta believe a lot of foul tips created a lot of big counts. But in this ballgame now, the White Sox are gonna try to get some left-handers in there. They got Sutherland, Squires, that Molinaro. But it looks to me, Harry, like Baines' leg is bothering him. He got a base hit in that 9th inning. And then Lamar got the double to drive in 2 runs.
They're all set to play down there. That's Joe Nosek there, isn't it?
No, that's not Nosek. I think that's, I can't think of it, but it's not Nosek.
Pruitt, Ron Pruitt is representing manager Tony La Russa in the pregame huddle. Then it must be...
It's Dave Duncan? No.
No, it's Dennis Summers, I believe.
Yeah, I don't know him. Yeah, he's got number 2 in his back. That's him.
Yeah, Dennis Summers. There go the White Sox onto the fifth.
Harry, I said Sutherland was playing left field. He's playing center. They're going to give Lemon a rest.
Miguel Delaunay is going to be leading it off. He had 1 out of 5 in the 1st game. So the 2nd game is just about to start. The Indians won the 1st game 4-2. You know, Milwaukee is trailing against Detroit. 3-1 in the fifth. Should Milwaukee win, they'd be only 6.5 out. Boston is 9.5 out. They're not playing tonight. Baltimore has moved to within 2.5, two on the loss side. Some young fans have a big banner out there in left center, and it reads, "Think about it." I don't know what's the inference.
A lot of big signs around here in front. They got a big one that says, "What's the odds?" I don't understand what that one is either. Another one, I think the one you said, "Think about it," just walked from right below all the way out there.
What do you think they mean, Jake? Think about it.
You're younger than we are, Jake. What do you mean? You don't know. Trout has no
record. I wish he wouldn't do so much thinking and do some more winning ball game.
Steve has no record against the Indians this year. He had an earlier start against them on June 6th at Comiskey Park. Game went 5 1/3 innings, gave up 3 runs, 2 earned, and 9 hits. He was not the pitcher to record. White Sox won it 8-7. Last season he was 0-1. So Trout, looking for his 7th win. His ERA is 3.46. He too has been having trouble with the ball club getting him any runs. Bob Verde seems to think, what's going to happen with these young pitchers? Are they going to get mentally upset if they have the same thing keep going on and on in the next year? And I said, I don't think anybody can really answer that. It's a tough question whether it would bother them. But so far, I got to believe that these kids have just kept pitching.
They haven't had much support, either with the bat or with the glove. But they still have done a very respectable job. Britt Burns lost that first game, but not a bad pitching job at all.
You know, a lot of times you win ball games like he pitched.
Here's Delaney to lead it off. First pitch, fastball high. Delaney, 1 out of 5 in the first game, now hitting 349. This game underway at 9:15. There's a fastball for a strike. That evens a count at a ball and a strike. Nobody on, nobody out. Just starting. Fastball inside, ball two. Steve Trout has won 6, lost 12. Fine earned run average of 3.46. Ball low and inside.
Borgman catching the second game. Kevin Bell, he's playing third, in looking for a bunt. Dylan A can fly.
Strike two call. 3-2. There isn't a pitcher on the Cleveland staff whose earned run average is as good as Steve Trout. Here's Steve, 6-12 for the year. Bouncing ball, deep short. Gonna be tough to throw him out, but they get him. Great play by Todd Crew. Holy cow.
Boy, this ball just gets by Bell, so it makes it a tough play for Cruz. Watch how he makes this play off balance. Now he throws, falling backwards. Watch this throw. Look, he's falling backwards and throws a strike. What an arm he has.
Speaking of falling backwards, did you see Delaney when he swung? He was back on his heel. Here's George Orta, had 3 out of 5 in the first game. Batting 305 now, 6 homers. 50 runs batted in. He shortened up the fastball, low and away. White Sox go over the 1 million mark in home attendance tonight. Good fastball in there. A ball and a strike. A little tap, that ought to be easy. Kevin Bell can't come up with it, though. It was a tough play to his left. If it gets by Bell, it'll be a hit for Orta on a slow roller.
This ball takes a real high hop, and into that wet turf, it's really tough as he slips a little bit right here and can't come up with it.
Had he not been able to cut it off, it had gone through the shortstop, I doubt if they could have had him anyway. So it's a hit. Here's Bannister, 2 out of 4 in the first game. Slider low and inside. Well, look at that name. Lo Derek. A-R-E-K. Bo Derek.
Lo Derek.
W-L-O-D-A-R-E-K. Let's see what it is backwards.
Oh,
K-E-R-A-D-O-L-W. Pretty tough backwards, too.
It's pretty tough backwards.
There's a strikeout. Two balls and a strike. Alan Bannister with 2 out of 4 in the first game.
Hey, come on.
The runner back.
I just took my glasses off.
Bouncing ball with a runner going. The hit and run was on, but it's foul. Joe Nasek coaching at third base. Tommy McCraw at first base. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Cardinals are murdering Cincinnati at Cincinnati. 10-1 in the seventh. Fouled it out of play, going into the opposite field with that. Bannister was trying to go into right field. Two balls, two strikes. Foul tipped again.
Bannister swinging much better than when he was with us. He was feeling the swings with us. He's ripping that bat.
Well, Bannister always was a good hitter. There's never any doubt about his hitting or his base running.
Well, they said that when I asked him about, you know, what was the real reason why, he said, well, he didn't hit much the second half and he wasn't hitting now. That was, you know, when they traded him.
Bouncing ball, hits the bag. It's going to be a hit. Runners at first and second.
Hit it right on the fist and hit it right on the bag. Two plays that Bell had tough time with. Watch this ball, Harry.
Not much you can do about this.
No,
one.
Nothing. Watch it hit the bag and bounce to his
over
left.
The fielder now.
Watch it go to his left. Oh, boy. Well, that's tough. Two singles to five. You put them together, they might not get to the outfield.
Here's Gary Alexander now hitting 208, 4 homers, 17 runs batted in.
Harry, good power, this guy.
Alexander. And Nancy plays a little Alexander's ragtime band. You're really with us.
She's got your butt,
Nancy.
On, Harry. She's got that vote for Harry for the mayor of Rush Street.
Yeah, next Sunday.
That's what she's got on it right there.
Oh, I jammed him. A little dribbler. The only play will be the first base, and they get him. Runners advance to second and third, and here's Toby Harrah. Boy, he saw that bat right off in Alexander's
hand.
Hit him right on the finger.
He hit him in the ragtime band. That's where he hit him. Here you'll see it now. It hardly gets to the infield. Watch it now. Just barely. He almost catches it.
How can a big man hit the ball so soft?
Now look at it. Just barely gets there to the third party infield.
Toby Harrah was 2 out of 3 in the first game. One of those two hits a home run.
Toby, a good low ball hitter, bothers me about the way he hits at this guy.
Curve low. 1 ball, no strikes. Nothing. We're in the first.
See?
Line smash fair. Into the left field corner. 2 runs will score. Boy, that ball was really creamed. Fan interference, a double for Harrah.
He hit a good low ball, curveball off of Burns for his home, and he is a low ball hitter. He just loves the ball down. Has he hit that ball down? Whoop.
No question about that one. Those other hits might have been fluky, but this was cream.
How many RBIs is that for Harrah, Coach?
That is 57. I think we could use him at third base, aren't you?
We can use anything. Anybody that's an average player that could get the job done is what we need.
Here's Bo Diaz, and the pitch is high.
And anybody that don't believe it is kidding themselves.
Two to nothing, Cleveland.
There he goes.
There's a man trying to steal third, and he makes it easily.
Boy, show the jump that Hara had on this. He's a good base stealer. For years, he's averaged about 30 bases, stolen base when he's with Texas. He gets a jump that you... we can't see the jump, but you'll see he really makes it easy. He's standing up if he wanted to be. That's when you got a tremendous jump.
You know, playing at home yesterday in a doubleheader against Milwaukee, Cleveland made a total of one run all day. Then they come in here and beat us 4-2 the first game. They're ahead 2-0 in this game.
Score was telling me that Cleveland had an 8-game winning streak, went into Milwaukee and lost 3 out of 4. They salvaged the last game of the series in Milwaukee.
Ground ball to the shortstop. That ought to end the inning. Cruz throws out Diaz. Two runs, three hits, no errors, one left. We move into the bottom of the first, 2-0 Cleveland. Caray back in the ballpark. We go to the bottom of the first. There you see some of the fans.
This program,
Tiger fan there, Jimmy.
That's a Twin fan. This program is owned by WSNS-TV. So exclusive rights granted by the Chicago White Sox. It's telecast solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any reproduction or play-by-play of the description of this game without the express written consent of WSNS-TV is prohibited. And there you see Wayne Garland, a young man who now is 29 years old, who had a rotator cuff operation, has struggled to get back. And you know what amazes me? He's got 4 complete games this year with 1 shutout. He's won 6 and lost 4. As I said before, he's in the 4th season of a 10-year contract for 2 million hogs.
Here we go, bottom of the first, Leo Sutherland, who had 1 out of 4 in the first game. White Sox had only 3 hits. Wayne Garland. 6-footer, 195-pounder, 30 years old. Sutherland leading it off. 2-0 Cleveland. Ground ball right to the second baseman. Bannister's got it. Over to first for the out. Sutherland went after the first pitch. One away. That will bring him... Mike Squires, the first baseman, hitting 271. George Brett extended his hitting streak to 30 games in a row. Tonight, with a single, his first time at bat.
What were we talking about before?
We're talking about Cleveland being making only one run on a doubleheader yesterday at home against Milwaukee.
Right. Well, I was explaining how they had their winning streaks, then they went home and they won 4 in a row, and then here comes Milwaukee again and beat them 3 in a row. So Milwaukee's been a thorn in their side.
One ball, no strikes. Pitch a little low. Milwaukee batting in the bottom of the sixth, trailing Detroit 3-1. Garland throws the pitch low.
You'll never guess who shut him out yesterday in that first game.
Who shut out who?
I don't
Mike Caldwell?
No, Mitchell.
Oh, yeah.
Sorensen won the second game.
There's a strike.
Mitchell couldn't get us out. Well, he's one guy we can beat.
Sorensen allowed him one run on the second. They won. Milwaukee won the first game at Cleveland 4-0. The second game 11-1 before 23,000. Squires is on with a base on ball. White Sox will go over the 1 million mark for the year in home attendance.
Did you get the attendance yet?
No. Birthday greetings to Mike Augustine from Maryville, Indiana.
Lamar,
9 years old.
Walked, struck out twice, and then with two on, double a drive and two runs in the ninth, the only two runs we scored.
Lamar Johnson now batting 266. Bob and Mers and Larry are here from Whiting, Indiana. So now, and Pat Edzia from Hammond. There's a pitch fouled off. Greetings to Amanda Harcourt, 93 years old, in Tinley Park. They're here from Christ Communion Church in Crown Point. Bouncing ball, shortstop, over to Bannister, one. Over to first, bad throw. Pull him off the bag. Allen still has trouble making that double play.
Yes, he does. This is a sure double play, even though the ball wasn't hit hard. Bosky gave him the ball perfect. And Lamar not running too well. It's a slow track. Now watch how he feeds him perfectly high right there. Now he comes across the bag, but he gets the ball off the bag.
So here's Nordhagen, who did not play in the first game. Hitting 273 with 14 homers.
Here's
a smash up the middle. Bannister has a nice play. Flips over to the shortstop for the force out.
I think it's one hit him, Harry.
Might have touched the pitcher, too.
Watch it, coach. I think it hit him in the leg.
I don't know whether it hit him or not.
No, it didn't hit him at all.
No runs, no hits, no errors. One left. At the end of one, Cleveland 2, the White Sox nothing. Harry Carey back at Comiskey Park. We're going to the second inning. Jimmy, we have somebody in the skybox
now. Yeah, a friend of mine, Tom Haggerty, in the skybox. Patio Party, Tool and Die Institute, and Bullpen One. Fun Services, Harry. I don't understand that too much, but it says it right there, Fun Services. Bullpen Two, Power Parts. Well, that ought to go well. They ought to get together, Fun Services and Power Parts.
Fun Services could mean almost anything.
Yeah. E.W. Blanchy Company. Nothing in the corner saloon. I don't understand that. That's the best place in the house. Nothing in the corner saloon, Jake.
Here's Gary Gray to lead it off. He used to be with the Texas Rangers. Slow curve outside, ball one.
You know, Harry, we got to watch here for another 2 hours. Look at Jake.
Boy. The Blackburns are here from Frog Hollow and Dixon.
He's got three different sweatshirts he's had on tonight.
Birthday greetings to Joe Maiden, Cedar Lake, Iowa. Foul the pitch back and out of play. who strikes out the ball. Gary Gray, who's had one home run this year.
He's had a great minor league record for home runs.
Hey, threw the ball by him, struck him out. One gone here is Rick Manning, batting 223. Two homers, 35 RBIs. Glenn Borgman is out talking to Steve Trout. Jerry Dibzinski's next.
It is tough to name. I got to break it up four ways. Like his body's broke up. He got that funny body.
You know, his name is really Jerry Dillon, but he changed it for business reasons. One ball, no strike, swung, and he fouled it back. Boy, a nice Polish name in this town. You got to be big.
Well, I don't think anybody enjoys kielbasa and eggs better than I do.
Hey, if it's free, you'd eat anything.
I didn't say anything about it being free.
Here's a base hit to right field.
Terrible curveball. Let's play that again. He hung a little curveball, didn't do anything. He took too much off, and it just hung there. That curveball's got to break quick.
One out, nobody on here in the top of the sixth. Ball four inside. Second walk-off Trout. Here's Hara, who doubled in both Cleveland runs in the first inning. Stole third. Bounced to third his last time up. One for two, and he has three hits for the doubleheader and three runs batted in. Well, the game in Cincinnati has been called by rain after six and a half. St. Louis won it by a 10-1 score. High drive to left field on a changeup, but Molinaro just camping under it. Two out. Now Bo Diaz, he's worn the collar in seven trips tonight in the two ball games. He's bounced to short and fly to right in this one. The Cardinals have got eight runs in the second inning, posted an easy 10-1 victory that was called at the end of six and a half at Cincinnati by rain. Change up, curveball low, ball one. That was the only game scheduled in the National League. The Cubs will be in Atlanta starting tomorrow night. Had a very successful weekend down in St. Louis, winning three in a row after losing the opener. Swing and a miss on a low breaking ball. 1-1 to Diaz. Tell you, Buckner had quite a series down there. In fact, the Cubs really sprayed the ball around Busch Stadium. Buckner had 9 or 10 hits in the series. Russell got his 10th win yesterday. He's pitched some pretty good ball over the last month. 1-1 pitch. Diaz chases a breaking ball into the dirt. 1-2 the count. And again, Trout hasn't thrown a strike to him. Look at this again. Boy, he is really anxious. Give him a 9-iron. Hits that one off the fist. He might have himself a hit. He does. He drops it into center field. Little bloop. A Texas leaguer over Morrison's head. And runners at first and third now. The two out. There's a case where Diaz chases two bad pitches and gets one off the fist and bloops it into center for a hit. No justice in this game sometimes. That's six hits off Trout. Now Diaz was overdue. He's now 1-for-8. Borgman out to have a brief word with Trout. He's a little bit disgusted with himself. The Sox are going to get somebody heated up in the bullpen. Might be Dewey Robinson. That's Big Ed. Ed Farmer beginning to loosen up. Here's Gary Gray, who struck out both times against Trout. Both times he's challenged him inside with a fastball and tied him up with it. Breaking ball, changeup curve is low, ball one. Come on, Steve, bear down. A smash hit to the third baseman, Kevin Bell, flips to Morrison for the force at second, and the inning is over. And again, Cleveland leaves two men on. No runs, one hit, a walk, two left. After five and a half in game two, the White Sox 6, Cleveland 2. Well, we have a third pitcher here in the second ballgame for Cleveland. Sid Mangi, a left-hander, coming on. There's a look at Mangi and his delivery. He is 1-4 this year, an offseason for him. A 3.09 ERA. This will be his 50th appearance of the year. He has 9 saves. Worked 67 innings, given up 54 hits, a good ratio there. 46 strikeouts, 29 walks. 9 saves with a 1-4 record. Tony La Russa's father taking in the doubleheader tonight. A little happier, I'm sure, about this one right now than he was in the first ball game. Stanton pitched an inning in 2/3, gave up one run on 2 hits. The run he gave up was Kevin Bell's 3-run homer. So Mangi on to pitch the bottom of the 6th, and he'll face Jimmy Morrison. Hitless tonight. He has struck out both times on a changeup curve against the starter, Wayne Garland. He takes the ball low. Sox have beaten Mangi this year in relief. Last year he won 12 ball games. He's been an excellent reliever. Boy, he throws that one away. Ball two and no strikes to Jimmy Morrison. He'll be followed by Borgman and Bell here in the Sox half of the 6th inning. 6-2, the Sox lead, getting all 6 runs in the 4th inning. Ground ball, knocked down by Herrera. Long throw, got him. Well, another look. Sharp ground ball, and Herrera had a little trouble coming up with cleanly, but his strong, accurate throw got Morrison by a stride. Here's Glenn Borgman. He's singled in to run his last time up, also scored. He's 1-for-2 tonight, and Borgie's RBI will hold up as the game winner if the Sox continue to maintain the lead. There's a strike knee high on the outside corner. It's Borgie's 3rd RBI since he joined the club about a week ago. Low, 1-1 to count. Base hit the left. Borgman reached out and hit a low breaking ball into left field. Two hits for Glenn Borgman tonight. Well, here's the game hero, Kevin Bell, who singled in the 3rd and hit his 1st home run of the year, a 3-run shot into the lower deck and left his last time up. With 2 straight hits tonight, he's got to be crowding the 200 mark once again. He was there briefly for 1 at bat earlier in the year, and then he went on a prolonged slump again. Ball one. Kevin's 1st home run since the 3rd of September 1979. High and away, ball two and no strikes. One on, one out here in the Sox 6th inning. They pounded out 9 hits. Well, Spillner is up and throwing, but I don't expect him to be put in the ballgame tonight because he's the slated starter here day after tomorrow. Ball three to Kevin. Well, I wonder if Tony will give him the green light on 3-0 with a four-run lead. He just might. Strike at the knees, 3-1. Oh, did he have a rip? Three balls, two strikes. That pitch was away from him. Full count to Kevin Bell. Foul tip. Still 3-2. Fly ball in the shallow left field. Delaney takes it for the out. So Bell is retired. Two out. Here's Todd Cruz, who bounced into a double play, started with a shortstop, Jerry Dubczynski. He popped up to Dubczynski the last time up, so he's 0 for 2 in this one. And on the night, Todd is 0 for 5. Start to mention that Borgman is hitting the ball much better this year than he did at any time last year with the Twins. Of course, he has played a lot more. Played down in Iowa and was hitting 317 when the White Sox brought him up. He just didn't get much of an opportunity behind Butch Weininger last year. Sid Manji from Mexico. And now he calls Bo Diaz, his battery made out. I wonder if they're talking in Spanish. This is the only game still in progress now. Farmer continues to throw in the bullpen just in case. Trout has been a little shaky in the last two innings. Foul ball. Out of play. 16,270 taking in this doubleheader tonight. That pushed the Sox over the million mark again. At about 1,010,000 on the year. Swing and a miss, strike two. Looked like Todd swung right through that pitch. Rich Dotson against Ross Grimsley tomorrow, battle of right-handers. And then the finale to be Kenny Kravick against Danny Spilner. Foul ball. Boy, that didn't miss by more than inches. Still two strikes on Todd Cruz. Two strikes the count. Two out, Borgman on at first. He strikes out on a pitch that was in the dirt. No chance to hit that ball. Todd has really chased some bad pitches tonight. First strikeout for Manji, and a third in the ball game for the Cleveland staff. So we've completed six innings here in the second ball game. Harry Carey will be back to take you the rest of the way here. The nightcap after six, the White Sox leading 6-2. We'll be right back.
Harry Carey back at the ballpark. We're going into the top of the seventh, 6-2 in favor of the White Sox. Cleveland won the first game 4-2. Here's Rick Manning to lead it off against Steve Trout. Swings and he pops it up on the infield. That's going to be easy. Mike Squires is there and he has it. One away. Manning popped to Squires. Rolling right along. After a long first game, the second game, the White Sox with a six-run explosion, climaxed by Kevin Bell's first home run of the year, coming with two on, have gone into a 6-2 lead. Funny thing now, we have played 15 innings tonight. 9 in the first game, 6 in the second game. Of those 15 innings, the White Sox have scored in only 2. The Indians have scored in 5. But the White Sox can get a split if they hold this lead. They got all of their runs in the first game in the bottom of the ninth, all 2. And they got all 6 runs in the second game in the fourth inning. So they have had 13 goose eggs, only 2 scoring innings. But one of those 2 could be enough to win the game. Now the pitch, here it is. High pop fly, that's going to be easy. Squires in foul territory takes it. 2 up, 2 down. The Cardinals, in a game called in the seventh inning, wallop the Cincinnati Reds 10-1. Baltimore beat the Yankees, Kansas City over Texas, Minnesota knocked off California, and Milwaukee walloped Detroit. Those are all the scores. 2 out. And here's Miguel Delaney. Nothing out of 2 in this game. You know, after a long first game, this one's rolled right along. Here's a pitch swung on, a high pop foul out of play. That evens a count on a ball and a strike. The same 2 teams will play here tomorrow night. And also Wednesday night. Then Toronto comes in over the weekend. Bouncing ball and down the left field line, a base hit for Delaney. He's around first, racing for second. Delaney doubles to left. Now watch, Kevin Bell has to play him shallow because of his tremendous speed. And that smash gets by him. Here's Arta. George is 1 out of 3 in this game, 3 out of 5 in the first game. He was their big gun in their first game victory. There's Arta waiting, 2 men around. Good fastball, strike call. 1 strike or nothing. 2 men around. Ed Farmer down in the bullpen. We're in the seventh. Again, it's in there for a strike call. It looks like Orta doesn't pick Steve Trout up at all. 2 strikes and a ball. Trout going for his 7th victory of the year. Off-speed curve outside. Oh, that just barely missed the corner. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Bouncing ball. Cruz ought to get it. There's the peg for the out. No runs, one hit, no errors, one left. We go on the bottom of the seventh. The White Sox 6, Cleveland 2. All right! Let's do it again! Better this time! All right, Nancy! Let me hear you! Take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the crowd. Buy me some peanuts, some Cracker Jack. I don't care if I ever get back. Oh, it's root, root, root for the White Sox. If they don't win, it's a shame. For it's 1, 2. Restart your line at the old ball game. Hey! They're here from Boone Grove, Indiana tonight. There's Leo Sutherland to lead it off. Nothing out of three tonight in this game. One out of four in the first game. There's a line drive to left, gonna be caught by Delaney. One out. Here's Squire. Squire started the 6-run inning with a base hit in the fourth and then stole second. Went to third on a hit by Johnson. Scored on a single by Nordhagen. Johnson scored on a base hit by Molinaro. And after Morrison had fanned, Borgman came through with a base hit that gave the White Sox the lead. 3-2. That brought Mike Stanton in to relieve Wayne Garland. And Kevin Bell greeted him with a 3-run homer. And that's the old ball game. That all happened in the fourth. Cher Bono married Charbonneau. Here's a line drive to left, a base hit. Squires gets his second hit. A single left. Well, Cher Bono married Charbonneau of the Indians. Her name would still be Charbonneau, huh? Funny, funny, funny. Where do you come up with these, Jake? There's a runner at first, one out. There's a little pop foul back into the upper deck. Right below us, strike one. Souvenir for somebody. 10,000 free back to school packs will be given to the youngsters August the 22nd. One out and one on. He had a cut and he missed. Oh, I tell you, the scene, the fervor of the crowd when the White Sox finally exploded for 6 runs. When Kevin Bell hit that homer. From listening to the fans and watching them on their feet, you'd have sworn that we had just gone into first place. Man, oh man, what magnificent fans they are. And if anybody ever deserved a winner, these people do. Line drive, fair ball into the left field corner. Here's Squires, he may score. He's around third. He's racing for the plate. Here's the throw. He's safe. Now at third. Lamar's out. Johnson doubles to left, scoring Squires, but is out trying to take third on the throw to the plate. The play went from Bo Diaz to Toby Hara. And if Dylan A to hit his relay man, they might have gotten Squires at the plate. Watch the replay. Now Squires is running. Dylan A coming over, but watch where he throws the ball. He throws it all the way on the fly.
And the out at third went 7-2-5.
So there is Lamar Johnson's third run batted in tonight. Gives him a total of 62 for the year. Here's Nordhagen. That play went 7-2-5 if you're scoring. The Squires scoring on Lamar Johnson's double. Lamar out trying to take third on the throw to the plate. Three balls, no strikes. Mungy. Three balls, no strikes. He walked him. That'll bring up Bobby Molinaro, who's one out of three in this game. Now he's being called back, and Ron Pruitt. Pruitt is going to bat.
Ron Pruitt will bat for Molinaro.
Pruitt, who used to be with Cleveland, comes out as a pinch hitter for Bobby Molinaro and therefore assumes the designated hitter role. Pruitt hitting 265, one homer and nine RBI. Cruz is warming up in the bullpen. Victor Cruz. Two-man out, a runner at first. Ball game in the bottom of the seventh. We're going to get through with this doubleheader at a very respectable hour, like about midnight. Jake, did you mark the starting time of the second game? We got the second game started at 9:35. The first game went 3 hours and 6 minutes. Pruitt takes a strike. One strike and nothing. Two men are out, a runner at first, 7-2 White Sox. Count evened up at a ball and a strike. The pitch to Pruitt. There's a drive, but it's foul into the left field corner. Two strikes on the ball. Well, I got one of the gangs doing at the rodeo tonight on North Lincoln. A ball and a strike. A high fly ball, short left. Delaney is there to make the catch and retire the side. One run, two hits, no errors, one left. At the end of seven, White Sox, 7. Cleveland, 2. Bob Birdy of the Tribune. Dozer's talking to Bob Gallus to the left of Marcus. There he is. Just a shot into the press box. We're going to the eighth. Bannister leading it off. Fouled it in the upper deck. Many of the fans heading for home now. It's after 11 o'clock. They said, I'd like to get home by midnight. There's a fly ball, center field, easy out. Sutherland is there, and he has it. One man gone. Here's Gary Alexander. Steve Trout about to nail down his seventh victory of the year.
Can you hold this lead?
No question.
No question. You got it? Okay. Farmer is biting at the bit.
He can't get a save unless he gets closer.
Or he went three innings, huh?
There's only two innings left. One out. Pitch to Alexander. Fastball inside. Since the first inning, Trout has been superb. White Sox have out hit him 11-7. Indians got out in front 2-0. White Sox are blank for three innings and then exploded in the fourth.
You know, Baltimore played their game against the Yankees and they're now entering California.
They're en route now, I imagine.
As long as we've been here tonight, it's 10 minutes past 11.
Let's see, Baltimore plays.
Did you say Seattle? We had it over here. Anyways.
There's a pitch foul back. Let's see now. Baltimore plays at California. Four-game series in California, while the Yankees are playing in Seattle. There's a foul ball again. Then Baltimore goes to Oakland for four games, and New York goes to California for four. So they each have eight games on the West Coast. Foul tip.
Boy, that went right off the mask of Borgman. Shook him up a little bit.
You know, I think over the long haul, day in and day out, Baltimore's a better ball club.
I do too. Watch this ball hit it right in the mask. Ooh.
Two balls, two strikes.
I believe it.
Because they throw a deeper pitcher.
You know, they've got right now, they have to depend on 41-year-old Gaylord Perry. Not that he might not be able to do it.
And Louis Tion is older.
Yeah, Tion pitched a great game here. Got beat 1-0.
Two balls, two strikes. Well, that's what those old timers will do when the chips are down. I tell you, Jimmy, I've watched this thing for a while too, you know. You can't do it with all young players. You've got to have some leaders on there who've been around, who the young guys learn from, learn how to win from. 3-2 pitch. Bouncing ball right to the third baseman. Kevin Bell throws him out.
Well, you know, Harry, throughout the years, the Yankees would always seem to bring one good minor league player in. Guy hit 350, a pitcher 121, and just fit him in there somewhere.
Two men are gone. Here's Toby Hera. A little excitement down there behind the Cleveland dugout. Down to the corner. Two men are out. Ball game in the eighth. Toby Hera, the hitter. Off-speed pitch low. One ball, no strikes. 16,270 paid raising the White Sox attendance over the million mark for the fourth year in a row. Considering we only had a contending ball game one of those 4 years, 5 years, pretty good.
Nice.
That's a great catch by Kevin Bell of a low line drive. Para lined hard to Bell. 1-2-3, nothing across. We're going to the bottom of the eighth, 7-2 in favor of the White Sox. Caray and Jimmy Piersall as we go down to the bottom of the eighth. It's 7-2 in favor of the White Sox. Victor Cruz will be the new pitcher. Rosell is going to play third base. Davey Rosello. And Mike Hargrove will be at first.
Cruz, 5'9", 200 pounds. He might be a little heavier than that right now. Has not had a very good year. Well, check that. His year isn't too bad. He's been in 41 games. He's got a record of 5-5. His ERA is 3.60, which is very low in this club. He's got 8 saves, so he hasn't pitched too bad.
So bottom of the eighth, and here's Morrison. He's gone to the bat 7 times without a hit tonight. So he would like to get one. He may test Rosello with a bunt right here. Swings and a high fly ball. Left field will be caught. And Delaney has it.
Oh, he's had a lot of putouts tonight, Aaron. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4.
So Morrison is nothing out of 8 for the night.
He's had 5 putouts. That's a lot of putouts for left fielder.
That's carrying a lot of timber up there, isn't it?
Yeah.
One out, nobody on, and here's Glenn Borgman, who got a big hit in that 6-run inning. Sidearm fastball for a strike. They welcome the Illinois State Police District 2, 3, and 4 here tonight. Low and outside. A ball and a strike. Most of the fans have headed for home now. Same two teams tomorrow night. Borgman had a swing and miss. Borgman's 2 out of 3, drove in a run. One out. Nobody on. High pop foul out of play. White Sox have outhit them 11-7, outscored them 7-2. Neither team has made an error. As a matter of fact, a whole night long there hasn't been an error made. Both teams have been errorless in the doubleheader. Two strikes and a ball.
About 5 hours ago, Brett got his hit in the first inning. He's hit in 30 straight games now.
I think it's the third straight game that he has gotten the hit in the first time at bat, which means he's not taking any chance on being rained out in a 5-inning abbreviated game.
You know, it seems amazing. What was it, 56 games, DiMaggio? To think
this thing, he's only got 26 more games to go. Wow, he's already hitting.
I think DiMaggio never had, you know, a rain 30. Situation. I wonder how many short abbreviated games he had.
Two balls, two strikes.
Some of us had trouble getting 56 hits in a season.
Now this Victor Cruz, all set.
Harry, how would you like to sit and have a talk show with DiMaggio and Williams for about 2 hours?
They could talk a little bit about hitting, especially Williams.
Oh, well, the other guy could talk a little bit about fielding and great world championships.
Ground ball to the second base. Look at the way that ball is bouncing. Bannister throws out Borgman. Two up, two down. Here is Kevin Bell now getting a nice hand. Bottom of the eighth. 7-2, the White Sox. Cleveland won the first game 4-2.
Boy, Kevin with a couple of base hits, that big home run. He'll have to win himself a job for a while. Well, we needed this win.
Now the pitch swung on, a long drive, deep center field. Manning way back, way back. Makes the catch. At the warning track. 1-2-3, nothing across. At the end of eight, White Sox 7, Cleveland 2. Caray back at the ballpark. We go to the top of the ninth. Steve Trout shooting for his 7th victory of the year. Good well wishes for Reverend Don Humbert of Richton Park. The game-winning hit will be credited tonight to Glenn Borgman in this game. His was the RBI that put the White Sox ahead 3-2. So the way they figured, that would be the game winner. But Kevin Bell got the big blow, the three-run homer that followed. Here's Bo Diaz, a high fly ball. Sutherland in center field makes the catch. One out. Well, let's see, the White Sox in the second game gone with Squires at first, Johnson the DH, Nordhagen, Molinaro, and Sutherland in the outfield. Bell at third. Borgman the catcher. Cruz and Morrison in short and second, of course. And they have won. We're going to win. First game, they had Lemon and Baines, Pryor, Kim, and Laws. It pays your money and you takes your choice. One out, nobody on. Trout allowed 3 hits in the first inning for 2 runs and hasn't allowed a run since. Strike call to Mike Hargrove. Hargrove in the first game had 1 out of 5 driving in a run. They see Ross Baumgartner there at the end of the dugout. Lamar Hoyt with his back to you. A ball, 2 balls and a strike. One out. The second city is about to leave. All right. See you later. Three balls and a strike to count. One out. We're in the ninth. White Sox lead 7-2. There's a fastball in there. Three balls, two strikes. One away, ninth inning. High pop foul. Nobody will catch it. Out of play. Count stays. Three balls, two strikes on Mike Hargrove. A three-run homer by Kevin Bell, his first home run of the year. Gave the White Sox a cushion in that six-run fourth inning. Three of the runs coming on his homer. Line to left center, a hit. Pruitt now playing in left field. Plays a Molinaro. One on, one out, and here's Manning. Manning's two out of three in this game. Nothing out of two in the first game. Not too many people left with us here now. There's a fastball high. One ball, no strikes. Lined in the left to hit. Manning gets his third hit of the night. Here's Jerry Dibzinski now. He's nothing on a three. Dibzinski, nothing on a three in this one. One out of two in the first game. Ed Farmer gets up in a hurry now. One more base runner. And he could qualify for a save. Well, a double play would end it here. Steve Trout is set. He bunts in the air, an easy out to Borglum. Dibzinski was going to beat out a bunt. He's angry with himself as he pounds the bat against the ground. Watch this now on the replay. He's trying to bunt, and he pops it up. Now let's see if we catch him pounding the bat. Watch him now. He walked out of the picture. Two are out. One more and it's all over. There's Delaney. Fastball inside. Well, we had about a two-hour game in the second game. After 3 hour and 6 minute game in the first one. Low ball two. Two men are on, two men are out. And the White Sox lead 7-2. Fouled it back. Two balls and a strike. Two balls and a strike. Strike two call. Well, we may be down to the final pitch. Two balls, two strikes. It is. Sox win. Delaney struck out on a bad ball. So the White Sox have beaten the Indians to gain a split in a doubleheader. We'll be back with the totals following this. Sox win. After losing the first game 4-2, being shut out on one hit for eight innings, bouncing back in the bottom of the ninth to score two and have the tying run at the plate, the White Sox gave up two runs in the very first inning of the second game, but then exploded in a six-run rally climax by Kevin Bell's first home run of the year, coming with two on. And that six-run outburst was enough in the second game. Here are the total. Seven runs, 11 hits, no errors for the White Sox. Steve Trout, the winner. He now has won seven and lost 12. For the White Sox, Cleveland Indians, two runs, nine hits, no errors. Wayne Garland was the loser. He now has won six and lost five. So the Indians win the first game 4-2, and the White Sox win the nightcap 7-2. Tomorrow night, the same two teams will be at it. 16,270 paid here tonight, raising the White Sox for the fourth straight year over the million mark in home attendance. And I tell you, these fans, without a doubt, must be the greatest baseball fans on the universe. All right, tomorrow night, more of the same. We'll see you at 7:15. Hope you'll be with us then. Now this is Harry Caray. Wishing. What do you think would ever happen here if the White Sox won a pennant? Listen to these fans. We just split a doubleheader with a team in sixth place, and they're wild. Well, this is Harry Caray wishing you all a very pleasant good evening from Comiskey Park, where the Indians won the first game 4-2, but the White Sox came back to win the nightcap 7-2. Hope you enjoyed it. See you tomorrow night at 7:15. So long, everybody.